back. We're going to come back to Daily Heat, we're going to go to Smash. So I'm not going to give as much context because I gave a lot of context last week. While I have options to leg drag him right from here, let's assume that I either cannot get the leg across that easily, or maybe for some educated reason, I just don't want to go right to that. And instead, I prefer to first dismantle the De La Hiva situation and then look to pass from here. All right, so that's the first step, is just dismantling the De La Hiva and engaging our headquarters. The second step is going to be to hit our smash. Now, because in the last drill, we went under the assumption that we were able to pummel our head to the inside, for this one, we're going to assume that we can't, and that our partner has a forearm across our collarbone, in which case we're going to look to come to the backside. It's like, it's not really the back, it's like the side, but it's kind of back. And that looks something like this. And from here, I'm going to look for, you guys know it. Yes. But again, right, this is a big sequence. It's dismantling the De La Hiva, it's putting your opponent in smash, it's passing the guard, and then it's a submission. It's like four or five separate techniques. So it's important that you work them in steps and develop them in steps. You don't have to get this in a submission. If you've never seen De La Hiva guard, honestly, you should just practice this. And I'll break that down for you. So here we go. Patrick has me in his De La Hiva guard. It's an open guard that's very effective at managing the lateral and explosive power of a standing guard pass. You can see here how he has his hook wrapped around my leg. This in and of itself makes it difficult for me to turn my knee outward and square my hips up to him. And in this case, he's got his non-De La Hiva foot on my thigh, making it difficult for me to step forward and square my hips in. What I want to do to neutralize this guard, because it gives him such an advantage because of the way that it can create angles off of me, so my hips face away from him and his hips face me. So one, a very effective way of dismantling this situation, squaring our hips up to our opponent and neutralizing the angle that they're creating, is the following. Right here. Or here really is better. All right, so one more time. So, I want to push down on both his legs. On the De La Hiva side, I'm going to take a tiger palm and go right below the knee. The reason I go below the knee and not the knee is because his leg can pivot at his knee, but it cannot pivot at his shin. So this alone is going to help to pop off that De La Hiva hook. Okay? With this hand, at the same time, I'm going to go down on top of the ankle, and I'm also going to push down, and it looks like this. But sometimes pushing down is not enough to get this foot off our thigh. And by the way, we never want to allow our opponent to have the bottom of their feet touching our body when we're passing the guard. Not just in De La Hiva, never. So I'm always looking to deflect his feet and never even let him establish this or this. But in any case, he has, no good, we've got to get rid of it. So not only do I push down on both, but I pivot on my right leg and backstep in a slight circular motion here. And then I'm going to step back and square up. When I do that, all right, I take this knee and point it out, and I sit on his ankle, and I don't let go of this grip. Common mistake is to come here, for, I don't know why, but people do it, and this allows him to bring his foot out and reestablish that pose. So now I'm back to where I started, right here. And I'm going to, again, sit on his ankle. I want to keep driving my toes and foot as high up towards his ear as I can. If his arm wasn't here, I should be able to see my toes on the other side of his leg, and they should be at least in line with his belt, okay? We come back. I'm gonna be sitting, and I'm gonna be pressuring inside on this hamstring with this knee, okay? Infiltrating his space, taking away all his mobility, jamming his heels to his butt, jamming his hips and knees to his head. All right. And from here, while I have other options, you can see I've been able to achieve a position that now he's slightly angled off to the side, and my hips are facing him. I'm gonna take advantage and will not let him go of his ankle. I'm gonna take my right shoulder and I'm gonna fold it over his knee so that his knee now is behind my shoulder. At this point, I like to look for an underhook on the arm, and now I'm gonna put him in smash. He's gonna maintain a frame on front of his body, no problem. Look how my knee comes below his knee. And that's okay, I'm gonna stay very heavy here in smash. And if you're just learning this, I suggest you just go to here like a lot, maybe even the whole night. If you're not just learning this, all right, this frame in front of my collarbone is gonna complicate me taking him out, going to his front side. No problem, I'm gonna go to the back side. So if I have an underhook with my right hand, I'm gonna forget about it, and I'm gonna come take a reverse grip on the top knee. And I'm gonna pin that down, and I could take my right foot out and then staple his ankles with my back leg. The reason I wanna do that is because I don't wanna take my right leg out, and then in an attempt to get to the backside, he lifts his leg and traps my ankle again. We'll recover this guard. All right? So I'll take my right leg out, which typically isn't too difficult to do this side, and then while pinning his knees, I'll staple with the backside leg. I'll reach for some sort of grip on that trap, and I'll backstep over my staple. Here I keep this pin, and I stay heavy with my left shoulder on his back and throw his back away so I get his top shoulder further in front of him than his bottom shoulder, as opposed to this. I don't want him to be here. I want to use this opportunity to expose his back, at which point I look for an S grip under his chin, such that the arm that is around his neck, the back of my hand is under his chin, so that you could just see my knuckles, and the non-choking hand is facing up with an S grip. While there are other grips, I find this to be the most effective. And now what I do is I circle to north-south, and as I do that, my right elbow starts to clamp under his armpit here. And I continue to circle as I bring both his shoulder blades flat to the mat. And finally, with his shoulder blades flat to the mat and my elbow clamped under his armpit, I'll drive forward with my left shoulder into the back of his head. I do not want to drive forward with my left shoulder and get his back off him. I want to pull his back to the mat and drive forward with my shoulder. So it's here. Patrick, so you can see, let me borrow Mustafa, please. I call this stuff and step. I call that stuff and step. Stuff, step. Fold. I like that underhook. As I obtain smash, he's got a form in front of my frame, so I go to the back side. All right, so always look into his front side. I'm just gonna take my right hand, reverse grip on the inside of the knee. I'll start to look for some traps. Grip with my left hand, remove, staple, back step. As I walk around, I throw my shoulder into his back and establish my S grip with my back of my hand just under his chin. I'll continue to circle north-south as my right elbow clamps under his armpit, and I bring the shoulders flat to the mat. Put the shoulders flat to the mat. I'll continue to take my hands, bring them towards my hips as I drive my left shoulder forward into the back of his head. Steps, we got 20 minutes, perfect, every rep better than the last. I'll come around, make sure you guys do. Any questions? All right, one, two, three.